Hi, welcome to How to Repair. Is your washing machine washing the clothes too harshly on a delicate cycle? Or do you think it might not be reaching the correct RPM on a spin cycle? Well, you're able to check this now using new technology called digital tachometers. They have been about for a few years, but mainly people like car mechanics have these because they would use it for advancing and retarding timing systems on a car. Now, what they do is actually send a beam of light to a preset point, which you can see here shining, and it will count the amount of rotations that a wheel does per minute. And this will tell you the RPM, revolutions per minute. Now, this washing machine, for example, there's a few ways that we would want to test this. This machine is a maximum of 1200 RPM, but it has preset 1,000, 800 and 600 RPM spin speeds, which we would be able to check all of these. Also, in the workshop manual, when in test mode, this machine should be on a clockwise rotation at 52 RPM and an anti-clockwise rotation of 52 RPM. And I'm going to show you how to actually do this either with the belt or the pulley wheel. By the way, these tachometers are very cheap now. They're not an expensive item, and I'll put a link in the description below. You can pick these electronic digital tachometers up for around £10 to £15, and they're a very useful item to have in your toolbox if you're repairing machines. Okay, the first thing you need to do is make sure it's unplugged from the power supply to start with, and we're just going to remove the back cover of the machine. This will give you access to the pulley wheel and the belt, as you can see here. Now, this rotates, and as it rotates, we need to put a marker on the pulley wheel. If it only had one clear point, we would be able to measure that point because every time it does a rotation. But because it has five points, sometimes it will get a false reading. Now, I've got a little bit of tape here, which I use, and it's silver backed, and I'm going to set that on the pulley wheel here. And now I'm going to set the machine up so it's doing 52 RPM in one rotation on the test mode for you. Right, I've moved the tape to this point because, as you can see, there's marks around the drum, and I'm going to be able to easily hold this for you so you can actually see on the screen. Now, I've set the machine up into calibration mode, or test mode, sorry, and I'm going to go enter the first test sequence. Now, there was no mark on this belt, so I'm unable to actually do the calibration or do the test showing you the belt. But we've actually set the point up. Now, this should be reading 52 RPM. So if I hold this closely for the camera and point it at the mark that I said, and we can see that we've got a reading of 51.3, 51.4. And that is in the clockwise rotation in the drum, although you're seeing the wheel turn anti-clockwise here. I will just change it over to the other direction. And we now will be able to do this again, pointing it at the mark again. And this is why I actually put a marker at the point on the pulley wheel where it's able to read. And as you can see, we have, bear with me, I can't see from this angle because I'm holding it for you, 51.4, it was at 51.6 then, and that's all perfect. Now, if you don't have the workshop manuals, and I don't expect everyone to do this, you could set it onto a cotton wash. A cotton wash should be running somewhere in the region of 50 to 60 RPM. A delicate will be a lower RPM, could be down to 30, 40 RPM. And this is because it's a softer wash. Now, I'm going to turn this onto spin mode. Now, this machine is preset with a maximum spin speed of 1200, so we will watch it all through the cycle. Now it will go into its variable spin mode, and I'll hold this for you and we'll watch the RPM increase as it goes through. So we're at about 160 RPM and it's increasing. We have a reading of 300, 400 just coming up. And this will increase. Now, of course, your machines will vary from machine to machine, but this would actually allow you to make sure that the motor is running at the correct RPM. And as you can see, this is spinning quite fast now and it is very dangerous. So it's very important to make sure you stay away from the wheel. It will even take a reading at a much further distance. And as you can see, we've got 700 RPM. ...800 RPM. ...900. Just coming up to 1000. We should be at just about maximum RPM now, and it's showing 1187 RPM. You must remember, let me just turn this off a second. You must remember that instruments need to be calibrated, so that is the reason why we might be out 20 or 30 RPM. And also circuit boards are set to a 1200 RPM on this machine, for example, maximum RPM, and they can be slightly out. But as long as you're within 5 to 10% of the actual what it should be doing, you're about right. I hope this video helped you. I'll put a link below to these. You can pick these up for as little as £10 if you hunt around. They're a very good instrument to have in your toolbox. And that should help you with understanding what the machine should be doing. One more point to note, on new induction motors, they don't have a tacho built into the motor. They work on the basis of the fields. With the old brush type motors, they had a tacho in the back, and this had a point or magnet which would count the revolutions, send the information to the circuit board, and the circuit board would increase the voltage to the correct RPM. The more modern machines, because it's a three-phase motor, is able to work it out in a different principle, and I won't go into that here. But there you go. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching. There are many more videos at the website with regards to domestic appliance repairs. And if we really did help you, you can always click on the Buy Paul a Beer page. Thanks again for watching.